What's up, guys? Y'all with me? MWS, I got an odd payment from you earlier and asked you what it was for, but it didn't say in the notes or anything, and it wasn't bought through the store, and RocketFan86 called for them in the room and paid for them. I didn't know what that was for. I asked you, but I never got a response. Sorry, guys, we had no sound. I just went ahead and went over the teams. I was already ripping into the case, since we did go over the teams. I'm going to roll with it as long as everybody's cool with that. My phone was off all afternoon, since so many people decided to send hateful messages about the Panthers' loss last night. My phone died at, like, I don't know, 2:30-ish today while I was in the middle of downtown Greensboro. I haven't got any messages from you that I've saw. Do you want to just take them to the next case, or you want me to do a refund? Buddy, I was in the middle of downtown Greensboro. I wasn't even at home. I have no idea. Okay, you want to take him to the next one, Joel? Or just use that as credit? Like I said, I've probably gotten, I don't know, messages from 40 to 50 people, probably a total of like 70 messages since this time last night, so I have no idea. I wasn't anywhere where I could take them out of the store or anything. I don't remember that conversation, but I believe you. But I do not remember it. Okay. I got you, Joel. Sorry, man. Tonight's just that kind of night, apparently. One of those days. Nothing seems to be going smooth. Sorry, Mike and Joel. Sorry for the confusion, guys. I see your message here, but I didn't reply to it, and I don't remember seeing it. Like I said, the phone's been blowing up since last night about the game. Let me change that on the spreadsheet here too. Gotta make sure I acknowledge it, man. Like, I may have just wiped it out, cleared everything at one time. There's so much stuff going on. We still good. Without further delay, let me get started. Shannon over here is gonna be giving me a hard time. Like, can we just break the case already? Phew. Yeah, this is an off night for sure. Things happening that never happens. Yeah, thanks for doing that, Joel. Everybody's got a team. I know you got the Patriots in this one, too. Yep. Teams and prices for all my breaks are always in the store. Faster you guys buy the teams, the faster we can break it. Totally up to y'all. If y'all want to go ahead and start grabbing some teams in the museum, we'll go straight into that after this break. Yeah, you are, Joel. I'm not that off today. Yeah, you got the Patriots. Still got people messaging me about things. I don't know why people just can't let things go, but, you know. That's like more mistakes in one night of filling a break than I've had probably in the last 6 months combined. Just overlooking. About too many. Alright, box one, guys. Let's get into it. Anything autographed or numbered will be top loaded and penny sleeved. No vet base ship unless asked for. And even still, if you want them all, I'd have to get you paid a little extra, but I can send like a couple of each if you want. It's the same three or four guys for every team repeated over and over. All non-numbered inserts I am shipping, even though a lot of breakers don't. Let's get it. Box number one, these round numbered inserts will be divided up evenly between the two teams on the card. So if somebody had, if there's three that are odd amount, the odd one will go to whoever has the least amount of autographs. If we have anything dual like that numbered, it'll be random off at the end unless somebody declines it. Same thing if we have a dual autograph, always goes to random at the end of the break. And same thing with points, be random off to the entire group at the end. First autograph up is Cousin Mario, Mario Edwards Jr., rookie ticket for the Raiders. Something like that. That Mario kid. Next up, at least one per case, normally more than one, Kenny Bell for the Bucks. That is the rookie ticket of Mr. Kenny Bell. There you go, Kevin. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, it's like a K and half-assed Y with the Bell. KY Bell. So we've had five NFL Inc. vet autographs to five, and we've also had five Super Bowl tickets out of our first 19 cases. Who's this guy? Ooh! Nice. Championship ticket. On card, David Johnson, 75 of 99. Going to Shane. There you go, Shane. What up, buddy? I don't think I pulled you the championship ticket yet. That's a nice one. That would be a huge boom in some rooms. In comparison to normal. I feel a big hit coming up. I feel a big one. Next up. For the 49ers. Rookie ticket of Taylor Heinicke going to MWS. Not Rocket fan going to MWS. Got it switched around right now, guys. We got it on point now. That's autograph number four, so we should have two more of this case. Mike, you must have sent me that man when I was driving or something. I had to go and have a meeting today. It was I'll tell you the whole story later. We'll talk about that later. It was a mess. Phone died on me in the middle of being down there. Had no GPS. Who's this guy? Going to my buddy Nelson, I believe. Yep, PC Nelly. Second Marcus Mariota I pulled for him. Championship ticket number 25 of 49. Got a little something going on with that top right corner, but it's not anything bad. It's just that typical how the foil rolls up, kind of. That's the first championship ticket that we've seen of him. Yep. The reason why I said I feel something big coming is because when we have David Johnson, almost every time there's another big hit in that same box. Oslander's break, son. Man. On card, Marcus Mariota. Let's get that bad boy sleeved up. I forgot to text Nelson and let him know that we were here, but he's in Hawaii, 5 hours behind. So more than likely, he's still working anyway. Oh, that is crazy. Championship tickets of David Johnson and Marcus Mariota. All right, so we should have one more autograph in this box. We have seen a few boxes that were short and only had five. That's all it guarantees anyway. It does say on the box, five per box average. There's almost always six there. That's typical contenders. We have a Julio Jones 134 of 199 playoff ticket for the Falcons. Hopefully we're starting off strong with the first box. That means we got some goodness coming with it. Keep it going through the whole case. And our last autograph is the ever-present Nick O'Leary out of Florida State. He's a badass of a tight end down there with Jameis Winston going to the Bills. And Sean said, I'm not hitless. I am on the board. So we had Nick O'Leary rookie ticket. Marcus Mariota championship ticket, 25 of 49 on card. Taylor Heinicke rookie ticket. Championship ticket, David Johnson to 99 on card. Kenny Bell and Mario Edwards Jr. There's six autos in that one. Two very, very nice cards out of one box there. That would have been an awesome personal box. Kevin says Brett Favre a time. How much, Kevin? Oh, shoot, I didn't even notice that Andy's got that VIP now. I just realized that. Look at Andy. What? Guys, if we can get Museum moving, we'll go into it next. There's 21 teams left. And the next contenders for After Museum is already in the store, too, with 27. Who has the Dolphins? Hawks in the win. Andy has the Dolphins in this one. Had a designated pack ripper, we could do this case a lot quicker. I will say though, when we first started, like first couple cases we did, it took me over 2 hours. I think we got it down to it's only about an hour and 45 minutes to break the case down. Since we started out with no sound tonight, had a little hiccup there. It might take a little longer for this one. train Wilson to open them. Oh no. I don't know about that one. Might be some claw and teeth marks and a little slobber on the cards when you got them if we did that. Garrett Grayson's a super short print for his rookie ticket. I don't know about the ice. I'm going to say 125. Box number two. Let's get it. What you got in this box? First up for the Chargers is a rookie ticket, Dreamus Smith. Dreamus Smith. Got a gridiron gear card falling out the mix. Just for the sake of time, I'm not calling out all the non-numbered inserts, but y'all will be getting all those too. Next up is a dangerous 115 of 199 playoff ticket. Excuse me, for Bowling Bob and the Seahawks. Next up, Ifo Ikpre Olamu, rookie ticket for the Browns. Going to Bill Simpson, I believe it was. Yep, Bill Simpson. That sounds like he may be totally new to Breakers. It's never a good idea, blowout, to have a screen name that's very close to somebody that's like a legit dude. You might want to think about changing your screen name. It kind of makes you look like a troll. It's like best advice, not trying to be a dick. But Blowout Cards has the screen name Blowout Cards. So when you just add an S to it, it almost looks like you're trying to be a troll and pretend to be them. Might want to like rethink the name, but I can kind of tell from the stuff you're saying, you're probably pretty new. These guys in here can show you how to see how much something actually sold for. Next up, for the Bengals, variation rookie ticket, Tyler Croft. For the Bengals. Who had the Bengals? Been a while since we've seen that one. Joel, you got the Bengals too, dude. You got the Bengals and the Patriots. Thought you had another team. Oh, Andy must be busy. He didn't respond earlier. Next up for the Bucks, rookie ticket, Quan Alexander. Think watchcount.com is your friend too for seeing how much something that went at best offer actually sold for. Watchcount.com. There you go. Shane's on it. Just have to put in the item number. That'll show you how much it actually sold for. Not just the best offer. I Oh, Devontae's a beast, Andy says. Two more autographs. Just a regular insert there. I don't know why it slipped backwards. Need something to spice this box on up. The Tyler. There we go. There's a nice one. Ty Montgomery for K. Nelly 83. And the Packers. That is a on-card rookie ticket. No Lions yet, Jeremy. We're just on box two, though, buddy. Yep, there's a lot of Dolphins fans for some reason. I know quite a few Dolphins fans. Not really on here either, just in person. Yeah, I didn't like to focus on Ty. Alright, that warmed up this box a little bit. We still should have one more autograph. Hard to compete after the first box we had, that's for sure. Our last autograph, not bad. For the Jets, that Ohio State boy. Devin Smith, that one is the playoff ticket. On card, 185 of 199. 185 of 199. Yeah, we had just a few base left. So we had the Devin Smith playoff ticket to 199. Ty Montgomery on card rookie ticket. We also had rookie tickets of Quan Alexander. Variation rookie ticket of Tyler Croft, Ifo Ikpe-Olamu, and Dreamer Smith. We'll get on into box number three. Yep, I remember you telling me that the other day about the Shark Hendrick. If you're not sure about something being a short print, if you think it could be, don't sell it. They haven't even released all of everything that is short print yet. They've only released a partial list for the rookie tickets. And they haven't released any numbers yet. So, I mean, a short print could be to 10 or it could be to 100. Until they release those numbers, we have no idea. The Croft is a short print. I figured it was. I think we've only seen one other one like that. That was the variation. Yep. If you a better list, RCC. That one's decent too, but the better list, even better than the Panini, is the blowout, or excuse me, Beckett. If you look up the list on Beckett, they've got the best, like, easy to read list. But like I said, that's not even the full list yet, and there's no numbers that have been released. Not unless it happened today while I was cut off from the world. I've got the link, but if you just look up Beckett and Contenders. Hold on. I'm pretty sure I've got it bookmarked. I'm sure somebody's going to beat me to it before I can look it up here anyway. Here it is. I just like this better than the Panini list because it's a little easier to read. You don't have to download it or anything like the Panini list. The Cardboard Connection normally does a decent job of stuff like that. I told you somebody beat me to it if I could even get there. I shouldn't even stop. Cardboard Connection kind of is like everybody comes together and posts their own stuff there, so sometimes things can be questionable. Yeah, it was released earlier last year, too, though. Not by much, though. They own it. There's normally a list of retail, two different lists they come out with of the hobby, and then they release the actual numbers that were printed. So far, they've only showed us one list. But I've already talked with a couple of people that sold stuff that, because they're on the short print list, they don't know exactly how short printed it is, but they've already sold them at very cheap prices. That happens every year. I always tell everybody, just wait. Hold off. If you don't see a bunch of them listed on eBay already, I wouldn't even list it. You never know. It doesn't have to be a big name to be worth a ton of money. I've run his break, son. What up, Jamie? We just on box number 3, man. We had playoff tickets of Mariota and David Johnson in the first box. We just had Tom Montgomery rookie ticket and Devin Smith playoff ticket. That's like the 4 best cards in the first 2 boxes. Hoping to go on into museum after this. If you guys want to grab some teams in museum, I'll see if we can go ahead and bust the museum case tonight too. Probably my last one. I am doing full cases too. Not any of that half box stuff. Or half case stuff, I mean. Box number 3. Let's get it. First up, we got a Gerard Holloman rookie ticket for the Steelers. Going to no shelter. Does he? He's a 7th rounder, pick number 239 overall. I haven't looked him up. I don't pay a ton of attention to eBay prices anymore, other than the price breaks. See what the guys in general are selling for. I don't look at specific stuff, really. Next up, Tyrell Williams. Rookie ticket for the Chargers. Go ahead, Tyrell. Show them something. Yeah. Until it, K. Nelly and Bowling Bob have both had the Steelers on one of my breaks here in the last little bit. I think it's going to be a really solid case contender. They just uncovered a nice one. Not bad here. Clive Wofford for the Raiders. He turned it on a few games that I saw. 142 of 199 playoff ticket. He can't hear me, so me saying it's not going to matter. But it was Tyrell Williams for the Chargers. Yeah, Tyrell Williams. Thought you didn't have any sound, buddy. Oh, okay. Next up, again for Bowling Bob and the Seahawks, is Doug Baldwin, 178 to 199 playoff ticket. Yeah, I hear you. I thought you were still there. Next up for the Ravens. That's a nice one. Playoff ticket, 23 of 199, Buck Allen. Javoris Allen, a.k.a. Buck. Went a little off card on that one on the own card auto. I walked by one today like 3 times. It's been a while since I've been the one to. 2 autographs left in this box should be. Yeah, that's a nice one, RCC. Bucks and Jags seem to be loaded at just about all 2015 products this year. Seen a bunch of both. Next up, everybody loves him, Deron Smith. Uh-oh, check it out. It's the variation playoff ticket of Deron Smith. 21 of 49, Joel. Don't see that one much. You really do have the Bengals. I'm not playing. I'm not messing with you. You brought the Bengals. It's the 16th team bought. Yeah, I went over the list. Apparently, I cut my mic off by accident. So there was no sound to it, but I did go over the list so you can actually see it. I just went ahead and rolled with it. I'd already cracked the seal on the box before I realized it. For the Eagles, going to Tron, Eric Rowe, rookie ticket. Yeah, that was Friday, I guess. Had it been Friday. That Deron, boy. And that's the last little bit of a box number three. So we had Eric Rowe rookie ticket. Deron Smith playoff ticket to 49, variation playoff ticket, on card playoff ticket, Buck Allen to 199, Clyde Wofford to 199 playoff ticket, two nice ones there, Tyrell Williams rookie ticket, and Gerard Holloman rookie ticket. That's been the hardest team in contenders for sure by far to hit with is the Eagles. Typically on a case of contenders, there's like 2 to 4 teams that don't get an autograph, maybe up to 6 if it's a really weird case. But everybody always gets something because of the inserts. Unless I do have like 3 or 4 guys that tell me like Pats Fan 87 that was just here. And ride out that say, you know, don't send me the non-numbered inserts. I just set them to the side. I know a lot of you guys just throw them in a comedy box and give them anyway, but I like to send those out. As when I was first starting out, especially getting the breaks, I always like to get that stuff. I'm overwhelmed with it nowadays, but you know, for anybody that's just getting into them or whatever, it's always nice to get that stuff, especially if it's your PC team. I don't know. This has been a different case than any we've opened, for sure. Seems like a different mix of dudes, so could be Nelson Aguilar time. Jeff says he thinks there's cracked ice in this one. Now, a lot of times we've been seeing the cracked ice will come in twos. We ought to see at least another one more big name to go with the Mariota. Now, who knows? See some second tier names too. Yeah, I've seen David Johnson. I'll put him up that level now. Alright, box number 4. Let's get it. Right off the bat for the Seahawks, Jake Waters. Jake Waters is a quarterback, and that is his rookie ticket. Oh, Lord. Kevin said he ain't trying to hear about Nelson Aguilar. He popped in, tried to get him first thing. I was like, your boy Sean done beat you to him. Bob says, where's Lockett and Rawls at? We ain't looking for Jake Waters. What's up, Josh? I don't even know if I want to, but I'm gonna click on it anyway. That's usually pretty good stuff when you post it. Alright, we got our first numbered insert. This one is for the Broncos. Demaryius Thomas and Peyton Manning touchdown tandems, 11 of 99. I keep on plugging it, guys. Y'all want to take some teams in museum? We can go right into that next. Flick it. Chris says, no, don't flick it. I ain't got no hatred for those guys. And next up for the Cardinals, we've got a rookie ink autograph of J.J. Nelson, that boy fast. That is non-numbered, which leads me to believe that it might be a short print. We've only seen a couple of them. Most of those are numbered. But they haven't released anything about the insert autographs yet. We had Stephon Anthony for the Saints. Rookie of the Year contender last case. I had never seen that one. Out of the 19 we've broken, I've probably seen like another, I don't know, 4 to 5 cases open total. That one might be as well. Deron Smith. That's the regular Deron Smith rookie ticket. Do you really? Well, then maybe not if you've got that many. Then again, it could be to like 100 like a lot of them are. I would think if it was that many, if you've got that many, it should have been numbered to like 199. I don't know. Just hadn't seen him a lot. Looking for three more autographs, huh? There's another one for the Cardinals, Marcus Golden. Rookie ticket. Oh, did you? Yeah, that one's definitely not a short print. Seen tons of the Marcus Golden rookie ticket. He's about to get like Deron Smith, but not quite. He's probably got Kenny Bell beat there. Well, there's one for the Jaguars, Michael Bennett. Autograph number 5, box 4. That is the regular rookie ticket. His name's Bennett. He ain't been in it. It's a story and he's sticking to it. But we got one more autograph, and I already see you peeping through the mix. It's going to be a redemption, so I'm going to set that down, and we'll do that last. There shouldn't be anything else in here, because that'll be autograph number 6. You never know. We have had a few boxes have 7. We did last year have a bunch have 7, and actually a couple have 8. I think we've only seen it once this year with the 7. Or twice. All right, good luck everybody on the redemption. Rookie playoff ticket RPS variation. For the Jags. Nice one for Leo Inc. Rookie playoff ticket variation. TJ Yeldon for the Jaguars. Or one of those kind of like second tier players. Not a case hit, but next thing behind it. We had a TJ Yeldon. We also had Michael Bennett rookie ticket, Marcus Golden rookie ticket, Deron Smith rookie ticket, Rookie Ink, JJ Nelson, and Jake Waters rookie ticket. Yeah, he likes to take the Jags. He took them in the museum a little while ago, too. He's a Falcons fan, but he does take the Jags a lot in the break. I see Bob. Almost didn't get on tonight, guys. I had an eyeball of a day. Disappointment last night really wasn't as bad as just all the hatred thrown my way. But today was wild. A weird day. Glad I decided to get on though. I was wanting to rip something so bad over the weekend. Almost went live Sunday. I didn't think we'd have enough time before the game started to get something filled. Oh, it'll be on there. I post every card on the Facebook group. But it ain't gonna be up in the hashtag Oslander's break, son. that's not true. It might be the first one in the three that you had. We just had a case that had a Tyler Lockett and a Thomas Rawls. Last case contenders, I believe. Had both of them. I can't be one of the teams. It seems like the Seahawks and Chargers are a little tough sometimes. They're only in about like maybe one of every three or four cases as far as either Melvin Gordon or those two I just named. It's still nowhere near as hard to hit as the Eagles. The Eagles have been tough. I'll give it a shot. We'll work toward that. In the meantime, here's a Darren Waller for your Ravens. You won in a special. That's a rookie ticket. We'll work on it. Old Pats fan, Jamie, that was in here earlier, I think I pulled him four Melvin Gordons. I think there's been like six come out. Six or seven out of like 19 cases. So that's where I'm getting odds of like one per every three cases or whatever. Which we have had. We did have a case where we had two Gordons. You never know. Eddie Goldman for the Bears rookie ticket. Oh, Kevin White for the Bears was really elusive for a while. We've been pulling him quite a bit lately. Not the last couple, but way more often than he was coming out. Yeah, he comes out a lot. So does Eddie Goldman there. So my guy that used to take stuff and take it to Girls and Boys Clubs and Duke's Children's Hospital and stuff, I used to donate my base to. He's in college now. He goes to UNC. He doesn't really have as much time to do it with everything he's got going on. I'm looking for a new place to donate. I'm thinking about starting to find kids that are getting into sports cards that might not just have the funds to get into a break or anything like that, or really buy a bunch of packs and start doing like whole boxes, like medium priority boxes for them. Tyler Croft rookie ticket. It's like, you know, 12 or 13 bucks for the shipping. Well, got all these bass, dude. I don't want to take the camera away from the cards that we got here. It's unruly. I've got 3,200 count boxes of 14 and 15 contenders bass. He said even if he could take anything else right now, he couldn't take any more of that from me because he's already got so much from last year. It's been a while since I talked to him, but yeah. Need to find someplace local to do it so I don't have to worry about the shipping. Like $20 or $25 a box, and maybe throw in some patches and stuff. I don't know. Just a thought. Do something for the children's. Randall Cobb playoff ticket, 172 or 199 for the Packers. I've been trying to come up with something to take them off my hands and send them to somebody that would actually appreciate it. Send the Randall Cobb to Andy. Okay, I'll set that aside so I'll write it down after the break. So we should have three more autographs here in this box. There's one finally coming up. And that is Dominique Brown for the Bucks. Another guy we see a lot. Dominique Brown. Alright, now, this has been another weak box. We need something to pop to spice it up. Like the last couple we thought was going to be weak. Two more autos. There we go. There we go. Woo! Stephon Diggs, on card rookie ticket for Mike MWS. I'm going to apologize one last time for the confusion because I sure didn't even see that message. I'm glad, cool enough dude like Joel had him on the other side, so it wasn't no big deal. That may be the worst autograph I've seen of Stephon Diggs. He does not have much of an autograph anyway, but on card rookie ticket. Charger set now. Winston would be good. Oh, that's right. I didn't realize you had them, Justin. Forgot. That would be nice to do a Winston with the Mariota. I've heard of that happening, but we haven't had it yet in here. Josh Robinson with the Colts. That is a rookie ticket. Whatever, Bob. My appointment was at 3, so that may have actually happened. I didn't see what time it was on there. I can't remember what he said earlier, but it may have been during the meeting. It may have looked like I saw it, but I was just making my phone quit making noise. And that was autograph number 6. Just a little bit of base left. We did have the Josh Robinson rookie ticket, the Stephon Diggs on card rookie ticket, Dominique Brown rookie ticket, Tyler Croft rookie ticket, Eddie Goldman rookie ticket, and Darren Waller rookie ticket. He went to Stephon Diggs since he wasn't anybody to really go with him. That was our weakest box so far. See if we can heat it up with this one. Be number 6. Ooh, Trump by the mountain, Tom. Vikings are available in the next case. I think they may be available in museum as well. I don't know if you guys might every once in a blue moon. It doesn't happen very often. But my archive on Breakers didn't record right for some reason. It didn't even show up. I tried for like 3.5-4 hours finding every archive from that night, downloading and uploading it to YouTube to see if it was the right one for the break, and none of them were. So I went live, I don't know what time it was, around midnight or 1 o'clock in the morning, did a recap of the museum. If you weren't here to see that in person, or if you didn't see the recap, check it out on YouTube. My first case of the museum was just nasty. The weakest link I felt like was the metal frame card was Duke Johnson, which, you know, Duke Johnson's, you know, pretty good. It just was a little bit of a letdown on the frame for me. But we did have Russell Wilson, 3 of 25, patch auto, jersey number. We had a Tyler Lockett. We had a Jameis Winston. The other case hit, the jumbo RPA, was Amari Cooper. I don't know, it seemed like that one's pretty loaded to me. Bob, how you feel about Marshawn hanging it up? Being a Seahawks fan. That's right, the 1-on-1 Brady. Dang, dude. Jeremy, I forgot to put your magnetic in there. I didn't think about it till just now. Oh, I shipped a card to Rideout that I had bought from him, too. I was in the heat of things last night. So, you're in this break, though. I'm going to send you another package. I'll send you one in this shipment. I got you, buddy. I got a whole stack of them right here. It'd just be a week later. What do you say? I haven't seen anything yet today, guys. I had the TV on for about 5 minutes today. When I got home while I was eating dinner. I tell you what, he is sure funny. There was a new one. He was on one, and then he set in on the Josh Norman Von Miller one. He does this like video game review on the Conan O'Brien show. And Marshawn was in two different ones. If you haven't seen those, they're worth watching. It's pretty funny stuff. Oh, word. Box number 6. He is a funny dude. James O'Shaughnessy for the Chiefs. Rookie ticket. That was the last team taking the break. Went to Sean by default. And she long gone, son. Where you been, Kev? We didn't need his gone, son. Yep, there's something about that, I don't know, the last two or three teams here lately, but that last spot typically does pretty decent. See if we can get some Chris Conley and Sharkhandrick West to go with it. As James O'Shaughnessy has not hit no much. But still, not hitless. For the Titans, Jalston Fowler. That is the regular rookie ticket of old Jalston Fowler. Oh, yeah. I pulled 5 Super Bowl ticket 1-on-1s. The biggest one being Amari Cooper. I don't know how much it sold for. I wasn't nosy, but dude sold it the next day after I pulled it for him. I shipped it to somebody else. I would assume $1,500 to $1,800. Zach Vigil for the Dolphins. That is a playoff ticket, 45 of 199. Also pulled the Sean Payton coaches Super Bowl ticket. Hawks in the win, hit it. I had the Cameron Artis Payne Super Bowl ticket. Gerald Holloman, which was a weak one for the Patriots. Still, I think Mark said that sold for like 125. And we had one other that I'm blanking on who it was. It was the last one we hit. It was another weaker name, though. Well, there's going to be there's more than one Super Bowl ticket for every name too, guys, because there's the regular rookie ticket and there's the variation. They both got Super Bowl tickets. So just because one came out doesn't mean the other one has. I mean, I don't know if the other one has too, honestly. Another Russell Wilson, this time championship ticket, 50 of 99. I can show you what it looks like. I got mine right here. They got the rainbow foil just like those championship tickets, but I'll show you. Since we're talking about it anyway. They're pretty, man. It's got too much of a glare on it being in the top loader, but see the 101 there. Did have a little ding to the bottom right corner. Yep, that one's in the very first case. They're sharp looking. Yeah, pretty much anything, man. There's 101s. Just depending on how many different variations or whatever. Doesn't mean that every player only has one. There's almost always more than one. Max Williams championship ticket, 91 of 99 on card for the Ravens. Yeah, we pulled some silver tickets. I don't remember. I don't think I've ever pulled a golden ticket. Last year, we pulled some silver tickets. Kevin, why'd you say that one I was the one that I pulled for you? That wasn't a silver. That was a 101, though, wasn't it? That was the Nick Foles base 101. Never mind. I remember. I know we had one of the Matt Forte silver tickets last year, and I know we pulled more than that, but I don't remember who they were. I've got one of the Cam Newtons from last year. Pats Fan 87 hit and sold to me. There's two of every silver ticket. Here's a nice one for the Cowboys. Going to Andy, I believe. Playoff ticket, Lyle Collins, 56 of 199. Oh, nice. Very nice. Those silver and gold tickets are tough pulls. I was so shocked. We had what was it, three or four? I think it was the first nine cases, I think it was. We had three Super Bowl tickets. I just thought that was unreal. Start to even itself out as we gotten deeper into the cases, I guess. Jordan Richards for Rocket Fan and the Patriots. That should be our last autograph in this one. I'm surprised you weren't in here when we pulled some of the ones last year, Kevin. So I know for a fact we pulled Matt Forte. I'm pretty sure we pulled several others. Not just like one, just at least one or two more. But I can't remember who they would be. I remember the Matt Forte because whoever I pulled it for was a pretty big Bears fan. They were excited about it. Now, we've already pulled about 1,400 autographs out of contenders this year, so it's kind of hard to recall what happened last year. And we opened 33 cases last year. Jordan Richards rookie ticket, Lyle Collins playoff ticket, the 199. Max Williams playoff ticket to 99, our championship ticket to 99, Zach Vigil playoff ticket to 199, Jocelyn Fowler and James O'Shaughnessy rookie tickets. Give me just a second, we'll go ahead and clean off these base. We're halfway through, fellas. Make a little more room on the table here. I don't know what's up with Gurley popping so much in our last few cases. Ordered the last five cases I ordered, there was eight Todd Gurleys in five cases. There was two in four of the cases, two in each of the four cases. One didn't have him. It was weird. And we had a case since then, in this second batch of five, that had two in it. I think the only combination of the bigger guys we haven't had yet, not including Tyler Lockett, because he is kind of considered a case hit, being on the package, I think. Most products he is, him and Melvin Gordon both. But just the big four, you know, Cooper, Mariota, Winston, and Gurley. The only combination we have not seen is Winston and Mariota together out of contenders. We've seen every other combination possible. But I have heard other people say that they have seen them together, so it is possible. Did you? I know Bogey79 there, my buddy Corey, said he had saw it. I believe it's who it was. Seen it or heard of it, one of the two. We are on box number 7 here. Nice. We've had four duels. Our nicest one was the last one. It was Melvin Gordon and Ty Gurley. Our three were kind of weaker. A lot weaker. I think that one was, who was it? Rashad Perryman and Devontae Parker, I think. That one's pretty nice. The other two are weak. I haven't pulled I pulled the legendary contender, Emmitt Smith. I think it was a legendary contender. Or was it NFL Inc.? I pulled Emmitt Smith. We pulled NFL Inc. Adrian Peterson. And we pulled Andrew Luck, NFL Inc. We pulled Darren McFadden. And then we pulled Joe Flacco out of the last case. All those were numbered to 5. Next up for the Cowboys, Gus Johnson, rookie ticket. Now that Emmitt Smith is sweet. What did you decide to do with it, Joe? Are you going to keep it or sell it? I hear you. I don't blame you. Next up for the Steelers is Tyler Murphy. This is a Tyler Murphy playoff ticket, 156. Of 199. Wow, you misplaced Adrian Peterson? Goodness. What's that? This guy, two cases ago, talking about, man, I had two bad case breaks in a row. Goodness. Talking about, oh, yeah, I misplaced my Adrian Peterson, but I got my Emmitt Smith. Guys that break for years and don't hit anything like those two. Delanie Walker championship ticket for the Titans, 57-99. I mean, I've never hit an Adrian Peterson or an Emmitt Smith autograph. Just saying. Yeah, I am. You know I am. I already have one time. You know what it is. Cheer up, Buttercup. There'll be brighter days ahead. I just got to remind Joel sometimes of the goodness when he has a bad break. Lucky Whitehead for Andy and the Cowboys. I don't know how you get Whitehead out of that, like, Z, it looks like to me. UNZ, I don't know. But Lucky Whitehead. Two of the three autos in this box have been Cowboys. We got three more. Andy says, keep them coming. He's looking for one of them super short prints. I know, right, Kevin? I see you. Me neither. I don't know. I think I could. I've hit one Adrian Peterson out of a personal pack one time. I traded it or sold it. I think I traded it into the local card shop for other cards. I don't think I could trade or sell away an Emmett. Cody Fajardo. I have to keep at least one of him. SPX, huh? There he is. Andy. Woo! Getting icy in here, son. There's an ice storm coming. That's just the first one. Very, very nice. Islanders break, son. That is the variation rookie ticket. 9 of 23. Oh, you're talking about the Super Bowl tickets. Just because I pulled the one Amari Cooper, doesn't mean the variation isn't still out there. 9 of 23. Kevin White on card. Cracked ice. Dude has been fairly elusive. That is pretty crazy to see him in the cracked ice. Man. That is nastiness. PC love for my boy Andy. Can't happen to a nicer, motivating guy. My boy, son. Next one is Taylor Heinicke. I believe he's a repeat. That's all right. After the Kevin White, we okay in this box. Rookie ticket, Taylor Heinicke. Well, I was thinking about it. I had him in my cart, and I changed it to the Bengals. That's the stories I get. I get three or four guys hit me up. You know what? I was going to buy that team, but very last minute I switched it to this team. Like, yeah, okay. Taylor Heinicke, rookie ticket. Cracked ice variation, the 23. Kevin White. Thing is sexy. Cody Fajardo, Lucky Whitehead, both rookie tickets. Playoff ticket, Tyler Murphy to 199. And Gus Johnson, rookie ticket. Maybe we need a Nelson Aguilar to match. It seems like to me most of the time when we get the bigger names in the cracked ice, there's less of the cracked ice in the case, except for that one case we had. I can't remember who it was now. It hadn't been very long ago, but we had like the five cracked ice, and I think three of them were autographed. There was two nice ones in that one. Most of the time when you see a really big name in the cracked ice, there's less in the case of rocks and like. That big hit rush. I got the one guy. I won't even call him out. I ain't gonna say his name, but he'll be like, man, that card hit, that you hit me, I'm still shaking, dude. I cannot stop trembling. Like, that's an awesome feeling, isn't it? Get that excited of a cardboard. You know how it is. We all in the same boat. I was in shock when I pulled that cracked ice for me. Can't believe it even happened. I know my old Panthers are still hitless. I think they went hitless in the last three cases now. Be nice to see some Devin punches. Don't have very many of him out of this. He's been elusive in my room. Sean, you sold that, right? I saw one just like yours up for sale. I know, well, I know you did because I know it wasn't you selling it. I remember you told me you sold it. Either somebody selling this, it's probably one of the other ones because I know it was number 20. I saw one listed. I guess it could be somebody reselling that same one. That's the great thing about contenders, Jeremy. First, well, for one thing, not everything really has a case hit, so per se, these days. If you're going to consider something in case hit, it would be that Mariota, and there should be another big name to go along with it, which it could be the Kevin White. But contenders, you might have five cards that you could consider case hits in a case. That's why contenders and national treasures sells better than anything else that comes out, period. Bar none. Hope that made sense the way I said it. Sounded kind of weird coming out. Sammy Coates is a beast. I might go along with that. Well, no, you got Cooper. I'd have to go Cooper. Sammy Coates is going to be killer there. We got too many wide receiver weapons in Pittsburgh. Wouldn't doubt if one of those guys gets traded down the line. Teron Ward, rookie ticket for the Falcons. Falcons on the board. Pretty cool looking autograph on that one. Jeremy, I didn't know you hadn't broke contenders before, or maybe it's hadn't broke much. I'm not sure, but some of these cases will have one or two cracked ice, may or may not be autographed, and in some cases they'll have five. Last year we actually had cases that had seven and eight. Keith Mumphrey, rookie ticket for the Texans. Ah, they say that every year. People say that every single year. And then when they actually hit the field, people start going crazy over guys after they have one good game. But it never fails. Somebody says, oh, next year's draft class is going to suck. It's going to be really weak. I guess you could have the argument on that for the 2013, but I never buy into that. Proof is in the pudding. We just had to wait and see how they actually perform. 54 of 125, Quentin Rollins playoff ticket. Check out that autograph. That's different. Yeah, well, you could have said Eddie Lacy there for a while until this season, too, for 13. Some other decent guys in 13, but that's been the weakest one since I got back into collecting. If you'll notice, that's why all the 2013 stuff sells so cheap, too, as far as boxes and cases. There's not as much value there. Well, hell, I did get something top loader worthy, at least. 71 of 199. Y'all's MVP, Cameron Newton. Too bad they've got the MVP contenders autographs, but no Cam. That's actually what the Andrew Luck was that we pulled to five, was an MVP contender autograph. And Quentin Rollins is a good one. He's a starter. I see another autograph coming up here, so I'm just going to uncover it.
We'll do it next. All right. Next autograph is a Rookie Ink 195 of 199 on card Rashad Green for the Jaguars. I don't know what that was about. I was not a fan of that decision. I'm not sure. Can't even really call it. If you notice right at the time as he went down toward it, about the same time as when it squirted out forward, so maybe he saw it already making a move and was going to back up for it. I don't know. I would like to hear what he's got to say, but I doubt whoever responds to that. It happened so fast, he might not even know himself. Next up, for the Falcons, he's a beast. Vic Beasley Jr., Variation Championship Ticket, 31/99. That is a sharp card. Love those championship tickets with the rainbow foil look. Well, first of all, it's a team sport. He did throw three passes that were too high, without a doubt. But beyond that, I mean, what did he particularly do wrong? If you really get down to it. It's not his fault that the defense was getting to him so quick. He didn't have as much time. He wasn't used to that. I don't blame anybody in particular. It just happened. Trevor Siemian for the Broncos. I think Chris had them. Don Juan Bob. It's a nicer looking autograph of his than normal, I think, too. Yep, going to Don Juan Bob. Kevin over there baking biscuits. He ain't even watching the break. Kevin over there cooking up some noodles of some kind. What the hell? I'm about to recap it. Cam always throws balls too high. We never see him throw a low ball. If he overthrows or misthrows, it's always high. Trevor Siemian, rookie ticket. Vic Beasley championship ticket to 99. Rashad Green rookie ink to 199. This is the one he's talking about, Kevin. Quentin Rollins playoff ticket 54/125. We'll put that one in the good stack just because Andy says so. He's a starter. Keith Mumphrey and Teron Ward rookie tickets. I would think something like that might be more of a kind of move like Blowout there was saying than the Cam thing. Yeah, I do realize that Philly Brown got a concussion pretty early on, I think, in the second quarter. It was, I don't know what time in the second quarter, but it was in the second quarter. He was out the entire second half. And he was considered our number one receiver, not Ted Ginn, when Kelvin got hurt. Now, I will say that kind of flip-flop and Trey Ginn probably would be considered the number one receiver, you know. But not to have one of your main dudes out there. What it all came down to was that pass rush. Von Miller won that game. He definitely deserved the MVP for sure. If you could have tucked him out of the mix, it may have been totally different. The Marcus Ware got in there a couple of times pretty good, but not like Von Miller was. I think there was 5 sacks, and he was rushed at least like 6 times. Now, if you were in the Super Bowl, and you scored a touchdown,
Would you hand it off to anybody other than family, maybe? Nah, son. That's why Fun, or who was it? John the Stewart, I mean, kept his ball. That Jeff Rowe, what's up, man? I'm alright, man. Had a weird day. But other than that, how you doing? Got stuck in downtown Greensboro all twisted around today. Had a little mini adventure. What's up, Jeff? How you doing, Mortar Tone? All you guys' packages went out today, by the way. I did forget to put a magnetic in Jeremy's. I have to remember that for this week. Alright, box number, what, 9? Yep, box number 9. Alright, Bob. Give it a shot here, buddy. You know, I hope I do. First up is Josh Harper for the Raiders. As a regular rookie ticket. Yeah, we need to. Hey, what's up, Eric? How's it going, buddy? Yeah, congratulations, buddy. Happy for Peyton. Vaughn definitely deserved the MVP. I think you were one of the people that hit me up last night, but most of the people who hit me up were really nasty about it, so I just didn't even respond to anybody. I let it ride for last night. I was actually busy shipping anyway. I didn't even see the messages till about 3:30. I heard them coming through, though, like crazy. 8 of 99, Jamaal Charles for the Chiefs. Yeah. As soon as the game hit double zeros, I got back into shipping mode. I guess that was probably why around 11 or so. I didn't finish till 3:30. I didn't pick up my phone in that time. Wanted to get that stuff done. Next up, Kamar Aiken for the Ravens. Like I said, 90% of the people were very nasty about it, so it wasn't worth responding to anyway. You were doing fireworks and stuff, I hear you. Here you, Bob. Only 3 cases, though, man. I mean, hell, I went hitless my last 3. I ain't tapped out, though. I've been in 20 in my room and another, 4 in Jonesy's. Come on, man. I probably went hitless in, like, 7. There's Alonzo Harris. You were just asking about him. Alonzo Harris, rookie ticket. I've only done 1 case in museum, and it was spectacular, I thought. I'm only planning on doing 1 more. It's in the store, and there's 21 teams left. Or, excuse me. Yeah, 21 teams left. Last I checked, I do have some emails that I haven't looked at, though. It might be some teams bought. Our first case was sick. I did put up a recap of it because something happened to our video. It didn't take right. If y'all go to YouTube and check out, it'll be the last video posted. It's worthwhile. It only is about a 10-minute video, so it won't take long to watch either. Our first one was a good one. I hope this sister one, too, it is, too. But that is probably all I'll do unless you guys really want me to bring it back. I did get 5 more contenders that are sitting at my mom's waiting to be picked up. I've already got the next one of those in the store down to 27. And we're already filling it, too. Yep, I've always liked museum. A lot of people don't for some reason. I think maybe it's the price point is the biggest thing. Rainil Hall, rookie ticket for the Bucks. It's just never been, for whatever reason, people don't break it for long.
You might be able to break it for a couple weeks and beyond that, and people seem to be over it. So I doubt I'll get any more. We had the 3/25 Russell Wilson jersey number. We also had a Tyler Lockett. We had a Jameis Winston. I don't even know what all. Here's a nice one. Somebody's been waiting patiently for a hit. Going to Jeremy, Vancar 108. NFL draft class, own card, Amir Abdullah. 107 of 199. That's my favorite inserts this year. Got that nice, clean, crisp look. The insert autos don't sell as much as, for as much as the rookie tickets, but if I hit that one, I will keep it. I don't have a lot of him anyway. That's a sweet card. We should have one more autograph hiding in this one. Kind of started off with a bang in this case. With the championship ticket, Mariota and the David Johnson starting out in the first box. Here's the other Kevin White out of TCU for the Falcons. He's also a wide receiver, but not the Kevin White. Yeah, I don't think Abdul is going to be the same bloodline as those guys. Kevin White, rookie ticket. Amir Abdullah to 199, on card, NFL draft class. Raynell Haar, rookie ticket. Alonzo Harris, rookie ticket. Kamar Aiken, rookie ticket. And Josh Harper, rookie ticket. Got three more boxes to go. Fatten pulled you a nice hit. Hope I got one here in these last three for you. Night, Bob. I'm going to still be trying, son. Keep plugging along. Totally up to you guys if y'all want to stick around and see if we can go ahead and fill a museum. Obviously, the more spots we fill, the pressure will be. Whether it breaks tonight or tomorrow. If it doesn't break tonight, it's definitely going to break tomorrow. We're going to focus on it until it breaks. We also have a contenders in the store if you'd rather get in contenders. That's what we'll be rolling with at the museum. We'll be doing several more contenders breaks. What's up, Clint? How you doing, Grayson? I didn't see you pop in. What's up, Herschel? What's up, Pete? What the hell, son? What's going on? Yeah, I do. I do. Didn't he have something to do with the source as well after he kind of like ended his career? I think. Wasn't he the one? Yeah. I think he wrote a pretty harsh article about Eminem early on. He got a lot of flack for it. And they had a little feud there. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remember that too, now that you say it. That's when I actually listened to some rap music. Back in those days. He was kind of a punk, though. I didn't really care for him in particular. I don't know that song you're talking about. I was always the Death Row Aftermath guy. Anything with Dre, with a Dre beat. Anything with a Dre beat I listen to. Exhibit, Snoop, M. Yeah. I still, I don't know, I listen to all kind of music still. I don't listen to a lot of rap anymore. Very occasionally. Some of that old stuff is about it. Not anything new, really. Box number 10. Let's get it. What you got in that box? It's heated up here.
Oh, damn. Old P the card man didn't even speak. Come on, man. Mario Alford for the Bengals. And it's like the 4th, 5th, 6th hit for the Bengals. Cheapest team in the break, just saying, only $24. They are available in the next case. Pretty sure. If not too many people stick around or we're not filling any teams in the museum, I'm gonna call it a night, guys. It's been a long day for me. Like I said, I'll be more than happy to stick around though if we can get it going. I know the tendency is to clear out of the room as soon as the break's over. Hopefully some folks stay and hang out with us. Well, we got our first random. Unless somebody tells me otherwise. 192 of 199. Tevin Coleman for the Falcons and Duke Johnson for the Browns. Not really a big one there. Somebody wants to give up their half. Can't remember who has what. I know Bill Simpson has the Browns. Who had them Falcons? Kings fan Bob. Set that one to the side in case we need to run a random. You talking about Jeremy Hill? Giovanni Bernard. That's that Tar Heel boy. He's from UNC. I hear you, Shane. I'm probably going to be a little sore tomorrow. I'm not used to all that walking around I did today. I assume I probably walked a good 2.5-3 miles today. Variation rookie ticket, EJ Bibbs for them Browns. Damn. I like Giovanni Bernard. Tar Heel or not. Who had these Steelers? Deron Grant, 6 of 23, going out to Jesse. No shelter. Used to get in Oslander's breaks quite frequently. Hadn't seen him in a while. He popped up last week out of nowhere. Getting some nice cards. Deron Grant. See if we can't hit about another 3 cracked ice in the next 2.5 boxes. There's Cedric Obingwe. Rookie ticket for the Bengals. Another regular insert flip. And we got a redemption. There should be one more autograph. So I'm going to lay that one down and do that one last. So we got a little stack. Should have one more hiding in here. There it is. Not a bad one. Justin Hardy for the Falcons. One of Kane's fan Bob. That one's an on card rookie ticket. Justin Hardy. Kevin's calling Philip Dorsett for the Colts on the redemption. I'm thinking it's Amari Cooper. Or Jameis Winston. I think it's a big one. Let's see. Joel says Matt Jones. Well, rookie ticket, RPS. Get some focus in our life. No suspense. Kevin nailed it. Philip Dorsett for Don Juan Bob, Chris, and his PC Colts.
And we had that one. We had the Justin Hardy on-card rookie ticket. Cedric Obingwe rookie ticket. Dorian Grant rookie ticket, cracked ice. Variation rookie ticket, EJ Bibbs. And Mario Alford rookie ticket. Oh, wow. You were tripping me out talking about how expensive Pokemon cards were the other night. Like $1,000. Like, are you serious? Like, my nephew had the original Pokemon card, the first one that came out. He had the Charizard foil or whatever. He was asking me about how much I thought it'd go for. I was like, I don't know, man. I looked it up and it's only like $200. If that's the most expensive card, how can it be $1,000? That's insane, man. There's gotta be something in there that's worth more than that, man. I don't know, I missed a few of the Super Bowl commercials. A lot of them I saw the night before in this special they ran too. Nah, I must have missed that one. Must have been going to the restroom on the Pokemon commercial. How you know that, Kevin? Trust I know. I was already asking that before I saw you say that. Is it like a Nike commercial? I don't know. Couldn't have missed no more than like 4 or 5. That must have been one of them. For anybody that missed some of this case, I will do a recap at the end. I like to do a recap after every box for anybody that may have got up and stepped away for a minute. I know it's a long break, and I do one at the end. I don't typically do recaps on anything but contenders, since it is such a long break. And box number 11. Let's see what we got. We got a Tavon Austin 168/199, who I thought was going to be a huge superstar. He's doing okay. I don't think he did as good this year as he did the year before, but I was one of the guys I picked the PC that year. Kind of just floundered off. Quit collecting them. And we got a redemption. Let's go ahead and do it. Who's this one going to be? I still feel like a big one's coming, so I'm going to say it's got to be Cooper, Gurley, or Winston. Matt Jones. Let's see it. None of the above. Rookie of the Year Contenders Autograph RPS Tevin Coleman for Canes fan Bob and the Falcons. I don't think anybody's even guessed him at all tonight. That one is live. Set the tape on Austin in the wrong spot. Well, I am running out of penny sleeves. I had another. Here we go. I gotcha. Actually had some delivered today. Carrying on. That was our first autograph with Tevin Coleman out of this box. Next up for the Saints is Davis Tull. Davis Tull is a regular rookie ticket. Still showing 21 on Museum. Totally up to you guys. If everybody, for the most part, bounces, I'm probably gonna call it a night. If enough people stick around and buy in, we'll go ahead and run museum tonight. Or at least start getting posed for it. Yeah, coaches on it. I just want to see one. That Kevin White could be the other banger to go with the Mariota. There's normally at least two. Right, there won't be more. How about a David Johnson for Shane? I haven't pulled you this one yet, I don't think. 35 of 199, Rookie of the Year contender, which is typically my favorite inserts, but I kind of like those NFL draft class better. These look really good, though. Something about this NFL draft class I like this year a little better. Ooh, that's a nice one. Well, good, good. Pulled you one you didn't have. Yep, Cardinals beasting in this case. It only took me almost 3 years, but I finally talked Shane into doing some football breaks with us. He's mainly a baseball guy. He's been hanging out with me for a long time, though, on and off. I keep on saying 3 years. Technically, it won't be 3 years till the last week in May, but close enough. Oh, my goodness. Garrett Grayson for the Saints. Super short print. It's only the third one we pulled. We just pulled one a couple of cases ago. Didn't y'all say this is like a $90 card or so? On card, Garrett Grayson, rookie ticket. Very nice. Oh, shit. What up, Eric? I didn't realize you were still here. I ain't been watching the roster there. Oh, man. Who had the Saints? I don't remember. I think Andy had them in this one. Yeah, Andy grabbed the Saints. Hope he takes over Breeze when he's gone. And he's got both variations now. Now, a lot of people don't like Trinity like we do. I don't know why people. I mean, think it's the best thing Leaf puts out. RCC said he just sold one for $90. Very nice. It's a nice bot. Look, David Johnson and Garrett Grayson together. Again, with the David Johnson with a very nice hit with it. We should have two more autographs here, too, in this box. And a whole nother box to go. Oh, my goodness. What a box. Melvin Gordon. Oh, man, that is sick. 20 of 25 NFL draft class. Woo! I was just about to say, I have not seen this one of him yet. That's why, because there's only 25. Yeah, no doubt. No doubt, Shannon. Trying to tell him. Blowout. Just because something comes out of one case has absolutely zero bearing on the next case, dude. We just pulled a Garrett Grayson, if not the case before this, two cases ago, and we've only pulled three out of 19. You could pull the same thing back-to-back, or it might be 20 cases away. That has absolutely no bearing on the next case, dude. They're all totally random. Even though sometimes it seems like there's correlation. Can never guess it, dude. I know, but like I just said, if it wasn't last case, it was case before. We just had him. That is sick right there. That was my original PC for other than Panthers and Steelers at the beginning of the year. On the RCC. That's sick, dude. Should be one more. I'm going to assume after three studs, the next one's got to be a dud, right? Not really. PJ Williams, again for the Saints. 5 of 99 championship ticket. Really, Eric? How is that even possible that that went that cheap? Well, I'll tell you this, RCC, if you're going to sell that anyway, I'll buy it. I will be the buyer if you want. I like that, Gordon. PJ Williams, 5 of 99. And that is it for box number 11. Gotta get some water, guys. My throat messing up on me here. PJ Williams, championship ticket, 5 of 99. Melvin Gordon, 20 of 25, NFL draft class. Garrett Grayson, on card, rookie ticket, short print. David Johnson, 35 of 199, on card, rookie of the year contender. So we had four studs in that box. Well, five. Tevin Coleman, rookie of the year contender. We only had one that was kind of a dud, in my opinion, in that box. And that was Davis Toll, rookie ticket. It was a fifth round pick. Yeah, I knew he had dropped some, but... Oh, okay. So, yeah, that thing shouldn't have went that cheap. I knew he dropped some, but dang. I know there's a lot of people that gave up on Melvin Gordon before the season even started, said he'd be a dud. And I know there's other people that have given up on him since. Not like he sucked, and it's also one of those teams where Danny Woodhead and, like, I can't remember the other guy's name, were getting as many carries, if not more, than him. Just like it is in Washington with a three-headed monster. So, I'm not giving up on him yet. I think Melvin's going to turn out to be a decent player. Well, not that he's not decent already. I think he's going to turn out to be a star, though. Yeah, PJ Williams isn't something very common. Are you serious? No way. Man. Well, let me know what you're thinking. I mean, it doesn't really matter what just the last one sold for. Some sold for higher. I mean, I give you like $25 or $30 break credit at least. Yep. I do. If you're going to sell it anyway. That's what I was saying. If you're going to sell it anyway, I'll buy it. I'll add that to my Melvin Gordon collection. And if you want to keep it, that's fine too. No big deal. No worries. Either way. Trent Richardson went to the Colts and stunk it up and got released and was a free agent last I heard. That is totally fine on me, buddy. Let's do it. Sounds more than fair. I expect it to be higher than that. Right on. So the next time you take a team, whenever that is, and it ain't got to be right now or whatever. Just remind me of that and tell me to take the team out of the store and I'll just get you to pay the rest direct. Alright. Last box, guys. If I haven't hit you something, I really hope it's in here. Contenders is one of these breaks where everybody should be getting some sort of package at least. Hopefully some of you guys will get in some other breaks this week with me and add to it. You have a nice package coming your way next week. I used to try when we were doing products that were a little less labor intensive to ship to get stuff out Saturday morning, so most of you guys got your stuff by Tuesday, but with contenders, there's just so much involved with it. I need till Monday to get it out. Eddie Goldman rookie ticket. Again, I believe that might be the third time we've seen him. Oh, I hear you, Shane. I have no idea. Kevin says he's calling Nelson Aguilar in this box. He's seen more Super Bowl tickets than he has Nelson Aguilar's. Oh, Let's search him out. There's a LaShawn McCoy for Sean. Damn, I'm surprised Sean's still with us. It's past his bedtime. That one is 137 or 199. I'm shady. Them inserts, son. I'm going to be shipping a whole stack of them. I know a lot of the rooms you go in, the guys won't even bother with those. If you don't want them, let me know, and I'll set them aside and give them to somebody. But I normally ship all the non-numbered. I've got two guys that tell me not to ship them to them so far. One of them's not in the break tonight. Sometimes I forget and send them anyway, though. I think I may have this weekend. I said after that game last night, I went in straight shipping mode immediately after clock ticked down. I forgot a couple of things as far as sending magnetics. Mario Alford, rookie ticket for the Bengals. And that is my last penny sleeve, so I need to grab some more of those right quick. Give them away. All right, well, that's the thing. I don't know if I'm going to give them to, but that's the game plan. I'm going to add them with those base, all these bases that I've got. Trying to find somewhere where I can at least get a tax write-off if I donate them. I know you mentioned to me one day some lady came in and saw me and was asking about cards for her son. I had no problem shipping her some stuff. Postage went up in the new year, so it's like $13. It's like 12 something. It's almost 13 for a medium priority box. I will fill one up. Anything more she wants to throw in, I'll throw in extra stuff with it. Penny sleeves and top loaders or whatever. The patch cards, I don't care. Whatever team they like, I'll hook them up. Tyler Croft. I think second one of this case. Variation rookie ticket. Didn't somebody say that was a short print? We had two in the same case. Oh, she hadn't been back. Well, if she does, just let me know. Give her my PayPal. Tell her to send me some money. I'll send it on her way. Yes, yeah, the third one of Rob. That one's the variation rookie ticket. There was two of those and one regular one. The difference between the variations, I forgot, Jeremy, you're kind of new to contenders, it sounds like. This year, there's always something different. See how this one's got the team logo? Even though this one's not an autograph, just showing an example. The variations have the logo. Except for the Browns, which just have a 2D helmet instead of a 3D helmet, which is just weird. But, yeah. Here's a pretty nice one. No, it's not what you're looking for, Justin, but Kwan's a beast. Possibly a short print with no numbering. We've seen like one or two of these. Rookie of the Year contender, Kwan Alexander. Oh, does she? She knows what's up then. Yeah, anything like that, man. There's some kid that's wanting, like, their favorite players or whatever. I have all kind of stuff laying around. I can put something together. The base would be free. Just pay for shipping. Anything extra, just throw in the money for it. I'll send the extra stuff to you. All right, we're going to save that for last. That could be the big one we've been looking for. There should be one more autograph besides that. I'm still calling Cooper, Winston, or Gurley. I hope. Now we got another nice Devin Smith, this time the NFL draft class on card. 16 of 199 for the Jets. Kevin says Gurley. RCC says Matt Jones. We see Matt Jones a lot, so that's a good possibility. Couple people have caught on to that. One of two or three people get the Redskins every time. Matt Jones, son. Shane says Cooper. Could be Green Beckham. That's true. We haven't seen him. Last of the break, guys. Thank you guys again. If anybody wants to jump in another break, it may or may not break tonight. It's totally up to you guys. But any closer we could get would be awesome. Just speed up our time for tomorrow if need be. Totally up to you guys. 21 teams left. And we're all wrong. Rookie Ink, Philip Dorsett for Chris, a.k.a. Don Juan Bob and his Colts. So we had the Philip Dorsett Rookie Ink on card NFL Draft Class to 199, Devin Smith. Quan Alexander, Rookie of the Year Contender. Tyler Croft, Variation, Rookie Ticket. Mario Alford, Rookie Ticket. And Eddie Goldman, Rookie Ticket. Before I do the recap, Canes fan Bob and Bill Simpson. Neither one of them are here. Instead of sitting here and going through an entire random for this like we would normally do, since this is all we have, I'm going to roll a die. 1, 2, 3 will be Tevin Coleman. 4, 5, 6 will be Duke Johnson. I would normally put both teams in and all that, but this will be a little quicker. Hopefully y'all can see this without going in screen share. Let's do this right quick. And it's a 1, so we'll go to the Falcons, Tevin Coleman. Only 2 cracked ice this case, but it was at least 2 decent autographs. 1 very nice one. All right, Jeff. Thank you, buddy. I'm sorry I couldn't get you a Winston. Later, Kevin. Later, Sean. I think they're already gone. Later, Shane. All right, blowout cards. I'll get you written down here in just a second. Appreciate it, bud. Alright, let me go over this case right quick. Variation rookie ticket, Tyler Croft. Unless I say otherwise, they're just regular rookie tickets. Mario Alford, Eddie Goldman, Davis Toll, EJ Bibbs, that is the variation. Mario Alford again, Cedric Obingwe, Kamar Aiken, Alonzo Harris, Ray Neal Hall, Kevin White, Josh Harper, Kevin Mumphrey, Teron Ward, Trevor Siemian, Tyler Murphy, playoff ticket to 199, Lucky Whitehead, Cody Fajardo, Taylor Heineke, Gus Johnson, Jostin Fowler, James O'Shaughnessy, Zach Vigil to 199, Jordan Richards, Darren Waller, Eddie Goldman, Tyler Croft, Dominique Brown, Josh Robinson, Michael Bennett, Marcus Golden, Deron Smith, Jake Waters, Gerard Holloman, Tyrell Williams, Deron Smith, variation playoff ticket. That's the one I was saying about earlier, I think. The 49. That was 21 of 49. Eric Rowe, rookie ticket. Quan Alexander. No, there's the other one. We did have 2 variation rookie tickets of Tyler Croft. Ifo Ikpe Olamu, Dreama Smith, Taylor Heineke again, Nick O'Leary, Kenny Bell, and Mario Edwards Jr. Some of our better hits, we had Rookie Ink Philip Dorsett Redemption for the Colts. Blowout cards, it all depends on you guys. If we get Philip tonight, we'll break it tonight, but I assume since so many people cleared out, it'll probably take till tomorrow to fill the museum. And I'm just assuming on how things normally roll. Every now and then we'll do 2 cases a night, but normally it's 1, so it probably won't break till Wednesday. But that's a guess. It's totally up to you guys. I wish I could set exact times for it, but that's not the way it works. But Rookie Ink Philip Dorsett for the Colts. On card NFL Draft Class 16 of 99, Devin Smith. Quan Alexander, Rookie of the Year Contender, not numbered. Could be a short print. Tevin Coleman, Rookie of the Year Contender autograph for the Falcons. 35-199 on-card Rookie of the Year Contender, David Johnson. Garrett Grayson, Rookie Ticket, on-card, short print. Might say it sells for 90 bucks. Melvin Gordon, NFL Draft Class, 20 of 25. P.J. Williams, Championship Ticket, 5 of 99. Dorian Grant, 6 of 23, Cracked Ice Rookie Ticket. Justin Hardy, on-card Rookie Ticket. Philip Dorsett, Rookie Ticket.
Amir Abdullah, 107 to 199, NFL draft class autograph on card. Quentin Rollins, playoff ticket, 54 to 125. Rookie Inc. on card, Rashad Green, 195 to 199. Variation championship ticket, Vic Beasley, 91 to 99. Cracked Ice, Kevin White, rookie ticket, variation rookie ticket, 9 of 23 on card. Very nice. 9 of 99 championship ticket, Max Williams. Lyle Collins, playoff ticket, 56 of 199. Stephon Diggs on card rookie ticket. JJ Nelson, rookie ink, non-numbered. TJ Yeldon, rookie playoff ticket variation for the Jags. Clyde Wofford, playoff ticket to 199, 142 of 199. Buck Allen on card playoff ticket, 23 of 199. Ty Montgomery rookie ticket, that's on card. Devin Smith playoff ticket, 185 of 199. David Johnson on card. Championship ticket, 75 and 99. And Marcus Mariota, very first box. Championship ticket, 25 of 49. For anybody who wants to hang out, see if we can get some work in on these other cases, I will be right back. Thank you, guys. Oslander's break, son. He gone.